But first, to the election, with just a week to go until the final voting day, all parties are gearing up to capture as many of our votes as they can. In South Auckland, this means having a presence at markets like Ōtara and Mangere. And joining us now with representatives from the National and Labour parties is Seinafolava Sanele Chadwick. Sanele.
Well, it's absolutely busy down here at the Mangere markets. Of course, a lot of talk this year about the Pacific vote, whether it's going left or whether it's going right. Joining me now is Peseta Sam Lotu-Iiga from National. Peseta, has the National Party done enough to win the Pacific vote?
We've done enough to get more votes. We're here to get Pacific votes. We think we've been good for the Pacific people, whether it's education, early childhood education for our kids, more kids are in education, more jobs. 111,000 Pacific people are now working. We believe we're good for Pacific people, we reflect Pacific values, and that's why we think we're going to do well with the Pacific vote.
Everyone turns out for election year, all the MPs come out, you see them on the streets. If you're re-elected into government, what's one of the first things you will do specifically for Pacific people?
Well, as you know, we're about building jobs, so the economy is going well. We've built over 83,000 jobs in the last year, and we want that to continue to grow. We believe our people are better off being self-reliant, depending on ourselves. We've got a better ability to look after our families, our kids, and our communities. Jobs is the most important thing, and that will continue to be the most important thing in our next term.
All right. Last week, a bit of a bombshell dropped when Fia Wilson-Turner. Did that damage in any way the chances for party votes for National?
Well, look, I'm not going to enter into a dispute between Fia and Sua. What I am about are discussing the issues that matter to Pacific people, their jobs, it's about accessible, affordable healthcare. It's about education, getting our kids, educated. So, today we've got 500 more Pacific people graduating with bachelor's degrees. That's 500 more than under the Labor government in 2008.
All right, your sales pitch for today, 30 seconds down the barrel for the Pacific people of New Zealand. What's your message to them?
My message to Pacific people is that, what are the values that you stand for and what are the values that you want from a party? You know, do you want aspiration? Do you want education for your kids, accessible and affordable healthcare? Then your party is National. We urge you to vote in the first instance, but we urge you to think about the policies in which have driven this nation in the last 6 years. We've been good for Pacific people and we want to continue that in the next 3 years. So party vote National in the days to come. We look forward to receiving your votes.
Well, that's National there for you. Now, to respond to that, we've got Sua Williams here, of course, who's from Labour. He's been here for a while now. Sua, how have you found this year's election campaign in Mangere? A lot of competition here for the Pacific vote?
Oh, it's healthy. It's always healthy, and we support the principle of democracy. Everybody's got a right to be here. Everybody's got the right to choose which party they want. And so it's been exciting. This is the last Saturday, and you hear the crowd. You see the young, youthful team of Mangere, the land of the young, beautiful and gifted.
Now, I asked about Mr. Fia Turner before. Is there a bit of dirty politics with you bringing that revelation this close to the election?
I think the dirty politics goes back to Nikki Hager's book, where it reveals that there's been a deliberate and determined pattern of dirty politics and the finger points of this particular government. Look, the issue is about, can you trust a party to look after the welfare of the people? And I think in the last 6 years, what has happened is the well-being of a lot of our communities has been going backwards under this government.
Okay, if you're re-elected into government, what are some of the first things you will do specifically for Pacific people in terms of policy?
We reduce unemployment to 4% as it was in 2008. Currently it is high, and high especially for Pacific people. We'll lift people's income to the 16, 25 cents an hour, the minimum wage. That is a way to put pressure on employers to share the wealth with the rest of the population. Poverty, child poverty, 260,000 children living in poverty. All of those children have families.
Okay,
most of those are in South Auckland.
Just quickly, 30 seconds pitch down the barrel of the camera. What's your sales pitch for the Pacific people of Aotearoa?
Look, this election is about which party can you trust are going to look after the people. People first, that's what matters. And it's about ensuring that people have jobs, high income, people with family are supported, and there are more affordable housing for all of our communities, especially in this year, in this year's election. And I'm asking you, cast your party vote for Labour. Vote Labour. Labour loves Pacific people.
All right, there you go. There is the sales pitch from the two major political parties here in New Zealand. National, Peseta Sam Lotu-Iiga, Sua Williams-Seal from Labour. I must say the Pacific people here are very tame, very civil here. A lot of love here between the parties despite batting for different teams. So it's up to you to get out this Saturday and vote for whichever party you feel will best represent New Zealand. Back to you guys.
Thank you, Sanele. Looks like a bit of a battle of the signs out there. Keep safe.